Hey everyone, Sam Evans here, and in today's video, I want to share with you 9 things that I wish I knew when I was 20. So, right now I'm 29, and I've been in business for I first started becoming an entrepreneur when I was about 21 years old, and it's been, 9 years that since I first started getting into this, and when I was reflecting on my journey the other day, I thought, what were some of those things that I really wish I knew when I'd gotten started? Like, what were some of those key pillar insights or lessons that I wish I had known back when I started that would have helped me through my journey? And there's a lot of them, but I decided to kind of synthesize them down into just 9 simple points and share them with you today in this video so that, if you're starting a business or growing a business, or if you're thinking about becoming an entrepreneur, you can take these lessons from my journey and apply them in your own. So let's get started. Now, the first one is a big one, and it is where you are in life right now. Take a moment to stop, pause, look around you, look at your life situation, look at where you are in life right now, and understand that it's solely you who did it. You're responsible. It wasn't anybody else who did it. You did it. It's all your fault. And until you understand that, you'll never be able to take control over anything in your life. Because if you live life thinking passively, life happens to me and I don't have any influence over my life, or, I'm a victim and all of these other people in the world control my life, then you'll never be able to make a change. You'll never be able to control it. And if you want to see, a lot of evidence of this, in a lot of the poorest countries in the world, there's a very high correlation with a religion. The poorest countries in the world are the most religious countries in the world. And I'm not saying that religion is a bad thing, but they're typically, their religion revolves around thinking that their life here, they've got no control over it, and then they're basically just here to suffer, and then they'll have a good life when they die in some kind of afterlife, right? Now, if you have that belief, you're going to be eternally screwed. And that is, kind of an extreme version of it, but, in your own life, you've got to understand that you've got the steering wheel. You've got control of your own fate, and it's all your doing. And when you understand that, then you're able to take responsibility for all of your actions and all of your outcomes from your actions, and actually, make some changes and some improvements. So that's number one. Now, the second one is business is all about solving problems. I wish I had been told this in the beginning. I went to university and I was hearing all about accounting and statistics, and then Porter's 5 forces and management by walking around and God knows what else crap that I got taught there. And I was just so my mind was just what is this business thing? This is so complicated. I don't know if I want to be in business. But what I wish someone had told me just day one, lecture one, year one at university is, all right, listen, the only thing you need to know is that business is about solving problems. You don't try to come up with a idea in the shower and then you just start a business. Business isn't about having breakthrough ideas in the shower. It's not even about ideas. You don't even need a damn idea. And everyone thinks they need an idea to get started, but you don't. Business is just about solving problems. So instead of trying to come up with an idea and instead of looking for ideas, look for problems. And you want to go out and speak to the world. Pick a niche, number one, a small group of people that you're interested in. Then go and talk to them, understand them, ask them questions what's the most painful part of your day? Or what keeps you up at night? What are you really stressed about? Really get to understand them. Get out of your own mind, stop thinking about you, and start thinking about a group of other people that you're interested in. Find out a true problem that they face, something that actually makes their life, painful. really understand that thing, and now you've found a problem. Not a problem for one individual, but a problem that's widespread among participants within a group. Now, once you've found one of those things, then the solution to that problem is your idea, right? So your idea is, well, how can I solve this problem for this group of people? And then once you've got an idea for it, that's a solution, then that, when you apply a solution to a problem and it works, then value is created. You know, value is a byproduct of applying a solution to a problem. And when you do that, when value is created, then people are willing to pay money. And the bigger the problem you solve, the bigger the money. And, you know, the best companies in the world, the best entrepreneurs in the world, the richest people in the world, the most successful people in the world, they just solve the biggest problems. They're not the best at applying Porter's Five Forces. They don't fuck Porter's Five Forces. Like, I can't believe we learned all of this useless stuff at university. It's just about solving problems. Like, you know, the internet was a huge mess before Google, and then Google made it usable for us, right? And then, like, Google is a great example of solving problems. Like, think about Gmail. Like, email used to suck before that. Now it's pretty good. And then Google finding things on the internet, like, I'm exponentially smarter since Google than when Google didn't exist. It's helped me a lot in my life. Imagine how many people's lives have been saved because of Google and being able to access information. Imagine how much the world has changed because of Google, right? And then think about, like, the iPhone. Back then, people used to have, like, a Navman, and or they might have had maps, like an actual printed map under their seat. And then they would have had a digital camera, and then they probably had an SD card in that camera. Then that camera probably had batteries, and probably needed like a USB cable and things too. And then they had all of these different things, right? And they had to carry a lot of them around with them everywhere. And Steve Jobs with the iPhone just kind of put them all into one thing. And that was, you know, that solved a huge problem. And so if you just look at the, you know, the most successful people in the world and the best companies in the world, they just solve big problems that a lot of people have. So forget about all the stuff that makes business complex. It's just a game of solving problems. So find a big problem, solve it. If you do that, the other things fall into place. Now, the third one, number three, is if you want to start a business, you don't need to go to university. You know, I went to university at first because I didn't know what I wanted to do. And I think university is a pretty good place to go if you don't know what you want to do, all right? Because it's better to go there and just be learning some things and hanging out with friends and drinking some beers than it is to be sitting on your own at home, like, doing nothing. You'll probably end up, like, falling into a bad crowd of people or, like, just playing Xbox and just eating pizza at home. And so I think, you know, university is a good place to go if you're unsure about what you want to do with your life. And that's because it's a better alternative than nothing. But if you know you want to be an entrepreneur, you don't need to go to university. You should, if you know you want to be an entrepreneur and you're currently in university, quit. If you know you want to be an entrepreneur and you're thinking about going to university, don't. Just start your business. You're starting your own business in the real world and will be a better learning experience than any university course could possibly teach you. Why? Because reality, there can be no simulation of reality or no abstraction of reality that beats reality at being reality, right? So university is an abstraction. It's a simulation and like a microcosm of what the real world environment is like. And so whenever there's an abstraction, it's not as good as the main thing. So go and play in the main thing. Start your business. Now, the fourth one is starting a business while working a 9-to-5 job is near impossible. And you need to learn to go all in or just get all out. Now, when I first started my business, I had a full-time job working at this corporate in New Zealand called Vodafone. And it was impossible. Like, I would try to work early in the morning, and then I'd try to work later at night. And then I remember even at lunch break, I'd go to my car, sit in my car, eat lunch in there, and then pull out my laptop and start doing some work in my car during the lunch break. And I was constantly like just in a lot of agony and pain because I was thinking about my business and all of these things I needed to do in my business, yet I was stuck here and I had to be present here, but I couldn't be present here. My body was here at the job, but my mind was back at my business, and I couldn't do either one well. I couldn't do my job very well, and I couldn't do my business very well. And I was just stuck in this limbo space in the middle. Now, I didn't make any real progress till I quit. When I quit, I was worried because I thought, oh my God, I've now quit my job. But everything from there got better. And it makes a huge world of difference when you can apply your full conscious attention to something. So don't try and sit on the fence between a job and a business. Like, go all in or get all out. Make a decision. The next one, number 5, is that lions don't care about the opinions of sheep. And popularity and opinions are false positives or false negatives, and you need to ignore them. Now, I know this one is hard. I struggled with it a lot. Like, when you first start out as an entrepreneur in business, you've been conditioned in society. Like, I started a business when I was like 20, 21 years old, and so I had 21 years of conditioning in society and everything to care about what other people think. Like, when you're talking to people and you say something, you're looking in their eyes and you're looking at their reactions to you, facial reactions, verbal reactions, and you kind of learn to optimize based on other people's reactions of what you're doing. That's how you learn, like, what's acceptable, what's cool, what's not cool, and it's, you know, this is all happening your entire life. But then when you go to start a business, all of a sudden it's like you become a black sheep. You know, it's like you're all of a sudden, everyone's like looking at you and criticizing you and thinking you're doing weird stuff, and they say things like, oh, you've changed, and oh, you're different now, and all of this stuff, right? And a lot of people think, oh, that's not gonna work, or you should just stay at university, or you should just get a job, or save for a house, or all of this crap, right? And what you've got to understand is that, you know, the moment you decide to become an entrepreneur, non-entrepreneurs' advice is no longer valuable, right? Like, they're civilians. You know, you change into like a different type of person when you start your own business and you become an entrepreneur. And, you know, it's just the same way like a lion wouldn't care about the opinions of sheep. You know, the sheep might gossip about this lion and say like, oh, like, look at that lion walking around doing these things. And the lion doesn't care, right? And this is what normal people do, civilian people do, when you decide to radicalize and become an entrepreneur. You know, you've put yourself over here, and now the sheep are over here, and they're going to gossip about you, they're going to say shit about you, and you've just got to learn to ignore them. And it's easier said than done. It'll take time. You can't just change this wiring in your brain, but the only way to change the wiring and not care about opinions is to just put up with them over time. Don't ask for people's opinions, first of all. Like, never ask for them. But what you'll find is people will still force them onto you. And then just listen to them. Don't fight their opinions. Just be like, yeah, okay, or whatever. Because if you try to defend yourself, you know, you just look weak, right? Somebody who defends themselves to some, like, civilian's opinion, it just means that they're unsure themselves, right? So you don't need to fight back. You just go, okay, whatever. And just understand that the best revenge and the best, like, fuck you, I was right, is to win, right? So stop trying to win like a little verbal argument with a civilian and just say whatever, focus on your work, and don't say anything. Just say things with your results. So you don't need it, when it does work, you don't need to go back to everyone and be like, I told you so. They'll know. Just make it work. Focus solely on making it work and don't defend yourself ever. Don't reply to people's criticisms ever. Don't care about their criticisms, just win. There's no better way to respond to criticism than winning. And then number six, when you first start in business, cash flow should be your number one goal. And when you have cash flow, that's when you want to start thinking long term. Now, when I first started in business, I started a business that, you know, was a longer term sort of business that I really didn't think it through. I tried to build like an online software platform type of thing. It was called Promote Yourself. And it was, you know, it was probably a good idea, like in the grand scheme of things, but I didn't give any regard to the short-term cash flows. Like I hadn't raised money and I didn't have much savings. I sold my car and I think I had like $6,000 or $7,000 or something. And then I had built this business, and long term, like, sure, we could get a huge amount of people using it, and when I had a huge amount of people using it, it would probably make a lot of money, but I needed to survive the short term. I had bills to pay, and I also needed to eat, and I also needed like staff and software developers and all of these different people. And I also needed dollars to invest in the business through marketing or these different things, right? And I didn't think about that. And in the beginning, or when I launched that business, you know, the future prospect looked great, but the short term I hadn't paid attention to, and very quickly we ran out of cash and we had to ditch it because we just couldn't survive. And so in business and in life, like, number one priority is survival, right? And survival is a short-term, immediate goal. Like, survival isn't long-term thinking. Survival's like right now. Just imagine if you're out in the wild, like, if you're totally by yourself out in the wild, your first priority isn't to learn calculus. Your first priority is to find some damn food and some water and some shelter, right? Or to evade the dangerous animal that is about to kill you, right? And so when you're in business, your first priority when you get started is survival. And the number one, like the food and the water that you drink in business that keeps you alive is cash flow. And so you need to focus on this thing first. Without cash flow, you'll die. And so I learned this lesson the hard way, and that business died. And then I got into a business where I focused more on cash flow in the beginning, which was like a consulting business. And this is actually what we teach people how to do at my company called consulting.com. We teach people how to start a service business with done-for-you or one-on-one services, solving a problem for a niche market. Because one, we're solving a problem for a niche, we're creating value, and we're doing it in a way that incurs low cost to us and can be done quickly and generates cash flow fast. It has all of these properties to it. So it's the best business, in my opinion, to start when you get started, because you're focusing on cash flow. And once you have that cash flow in place, then there's another mistake people make, right? And I made this one myself too. With my first business, I thought too long-term, didn't focus on the short, failed. Then I started my consulting business, focused on the short-term, got cash flows in place, but then I didn't think long-term, right? So I made the inverse problem. I made the inverse mistake. And then I stayed in this space for too long. I just kept focusing on cash flow, but then, you know, it just dawned on me that, like, am I just going to keep focusing on cash flow, like, with this small little business, like, not tackling anything major for the rest of my life? Surely this isn't it. And so then I realized that I'd made another mistake, which was, once cash flow was sorted, I didn't fix my eyes on, like, larger, greater horizons. So once you conquer that first mountain of cash flow, you've got to keep that cash flow flowing. But then you need to look for bigger horizons. That's when you start thinking longer term. So priority number one is survival through cash flow. Priority number two, once that's in place, is long-term thinking. Start thinking about solving something big. Because, you know, you can't really tackle big problems that take a long amount of time and incur quite a lot of cost and resources until you first have some kind of feeding mechanism in place that's going to be spinning off cash and resources for you to fund this you know, this great venture. And so that's my advice for you. And then number seven. So when you're lost and confused, focus on the customer and what's best for them, and then everything else will follow. So as an entrepreneur, you can just get completely confused and surrounded by so much information, so many different opinions, so many different things to do, and it's kind of like you're in a blizzard. And if you imagine you're in a blizzard, you're just surrounded by all of the snow coming down around you everywhere. You can't really see. And this is kind of what it feels like when you're an entrepreneur and you get lost. And when you find yourself in one of those situations, which will happen a lot, by the way, then you need to have a little mechanism to get yourself out of that. And the best thing I've found is to focus on the customer and what's best for them, and then everything else will follow from there. That's my one kind of true north Polaris star kind of thing that gets me out of blizzards. And the reason why this works is because it comes back to the first principles of business. It's like business is solving problems. Who has problems? Humans. And then typically we're solving problems for human participants within a wider group, which we call a niche. So just come back to those first principles. And you want to ask yourself, like, what is my niche? Then what, like, who are some of the people within my niche? Who are the humans? And then what is their problem? What's that problem like? Then what solution am I offering to them? How does that create value? And how can I make that better? You know, how can I understand their problem better? How can I make the solution to that problem better? And then how can I add more value to them? How can I do anything in this little area to make that better? Because I see entrepreneurs all the time, and this happened to me a lot too. I'm not, all of these mistakes I made, that's how I learned them as lessons. But, you know, there's so much stuff out there that you think, oh, I need to focus on marketing or ads or my social media, or, oh, I need to become an influencer, or I need to write a book, I need to create a blog or a podcast, or, oh, I need to be on Oprah, or I need to be in the New York Times. None of that shit matters, honestly. You just got to come back to the first principles. Focus on the customer and everything else will follow. Solve their problem better than anybody else and you will win. It's not a game of who's got the most books. It's not a game of, like, who's been on Oprah the most. None of these things are real. The only thing that matters is solving the problem for your customer better than anybody else. So just focus on that. And now, the number eight. So stay lean and frugal. And if you buy things you don't need, soon you will have to sell things that you do need. And I see people do this all the time in business. It's a classic one. Is once they start making some money, they start buying lots of toys and they start getting sloppy. And they, you know, when then it's a very slippery slope once you start getting into this whole lifestyle thing, right? And you start to have something called lifestyle creep. And it's like it just keeps creeping, and it's a silent little creeper that before you know it, it's like surrounded you like a, and it's suffocating you. It's like this big boa constrictor that's just wrapped itself around you and is squeezing you to death. And at that point, you're going to start pulling the chain on your business. So your business then is not going to be a vehicle that provides value and solves problems for people. It's going to become some kind of slave animal with a chain around its neck that you just keep pulling whenever you need money for yourself to get this giant boa constrictor suffocating you off your back for a little bit, right? And this is quickly what happens to a lot of people. They start a business and it works because they're solving a problem for people. And then they start taking the rewards from that business, like the money, and spending it on themselves and being an idiot and buying all of this useless shit they don't need. And then, very quickly, because their mind's over here and they're focusing on this, that the business is no longer like solving the problems like it once was. The business starts to suffer a little bit, and then this person's lifestyle costs keep going up, but this business flatlines or declines a little bit, and now they start choking the business for these emergency cash flows, And then the business starts going down, 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 down because they're not treating it like a value mechanism anymore. And this only ends one way, and it's failure. And then these people, they start selling things or cutting things that they do need, like different staff or different systems or, you know, these different things that made their business better. They start getting rid of these and they start like hurting customer relationships just so they can keep things they don't need. And it's mindless. It's moronic. Don't do it. Don't make this mistake. You want to keep the main thing, right? And you'll find that pro athletes, they don't let the money that they make from their craft distract them from their craft. Like a lot of athletes do it, they start making money from being good at the game. So then they start being popular and famous and buying all of these toys. And then now they're focusing on this instead of being the best in the game. And when they stop being very good in the game, then, you know, because they're focusing on this, then they can no longer have this and it just disappears. And it's like a mind trick. You have to focus on the game and the first principles, and that's always going to be solving the problem for your customers better than anybody else. And keep your lifestyle lean and simple. It's, you know, it's so much more freeing and nice when it doesn't cost that much money for you to live month after month, and you're not trying to look like you're successful. Like, people who are successful don't need to try and look like they're successful. They just know, right? That's why, like, the CEO or Larry Page and Sergey Brin, they had a Prius when they were billionaires. Jeff Bezos, when he was a billionaire, he had like a $3,000 Honda Accord, right? Billionaires don't have fancy cars. Billionaires don't wear fancy clothes and things like that. They don't need to look like it because they are it. And quite often you'll find the people who try to look like it aren't it, because they're trying to put some, you know, some artificial clothes, but the emperor really doesn't have any clothes. But emperors with clothes, they don't need to wear fancy costumes. And finally, number 9, focus is a superpower. And you need to learn to keep the main thing the main thing. And this is the number one thing that I've probably learned in business. Once you understand like what your niche is, what their problem is, and then once you've come up with a good solution that works for them and it creates value in a way that they pay money to you for that solution, then you just need to never forget that. That's it. And the only thing you need to do is remember this and keep working on making it better. Just keep making it better. And the only way you can really mess this up is by forgetting it or not making it better. Because if you forget it and you get distracted, then you're done, like, because it's going to go to shit. But the other thing is if you keep focusing on it but not making it better, then someone else will come along and make it better. And then they'll take it away from you. So once you've found this thing, you just need to focus on it. And focus is like a superpower that everyone's forgotten how to use. And you have to really be able to focus, you need to sacrifice. And a lot of people don't want to sacrifice. They don't want to get rid of all of these hobbies or not go out on the weekends and drink and do all of this stuff. But you need to understand that if you don't sacrifice for your goal will become the sacrifice. You cannot have it all. And so I've had to give up, you know, partying. I don't drink alcohol anymore. I don't go out and do all of these different hobbies. I don't watch all of this TV stuff. I've had to sacrifice a lot of things, but it's okay because I am happy to do that. I'm happy to make that trade for this thing because I want that thing and I enjoy that thing so much. And you'll need to understand this throughout your career in business because you'll constantly have to make decisions where you have to sacrifice things. There's no way to keep both. There's no way to do both. There's no way to keep it all. It doesn't work that way. You have to clear out the trophies of your past and you have to sacrifice things. And it's going to be painful and emotional. You're going to be attached to a lot of these things, but you have to let them go. That's the only way to keep climbing. is you need to drop baggage. You need to get a lighter pack so you can keep going. And so those are the 9 things that I wish I had known when I was 20. So I hope those 9 things help you. And if you enjoyed this video, just click that like button. And also subscribe. I release a video like this once a week on my YouTube channel. And also let me know what you thought in the comment section below. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one next week.